Welcome. Welcome, dear student. In one another session, myself, Mrs. Darshana Sandeep Shinde from KKWIOP. Today we deal with the topic chemotherapy of leprosy, or it is also known as the chemotherapy of microbial diseases. Let's start our session. Learning outcomes of our today's session. After watching this video, students are able to understand and recognize what is the chemotherapy of leprosy. What are different drugs used in leprosy, like the sulfones, diammono, diphenyl, thiourea, rifampicin, chaul mugra, and hydrocarpus oils. First of all, we see the chemotherapy of leprosy. Leprosy is a disease caused by Mycobacterium organism, or it may be known as the Mycobacterium leprae, which cause the characteristic lesions in the skin and the peripheral neurons. This disease is specifically affect on the skin and the peripheral neurons. That's why our tissue, soft tissues, cartilage are damaged one, and they permanently damage. We see the different drug used in the leprosy. Drugs commonly used in the leprosy are as follows. First is the sulfones. These are derivative of 4,4 diamino diphenyl sulfone, or it may be known as DDS or Dapsone. Sulfones are chemically related to the sulfonamides and are very useful in the treatment of the leprosy. Though many sulfone derivatives are available, Dapsone is a drug of choice in the leprosy. We see the pharmacological action of the sulfone or DDS. Sulfones are bacteriostatic in nature. That means they prevent the growth of that Mycobacterium leprae. The mechanism of action is probably like the sulfonamides, similar to that of the sulfones. Also exert a bacteriostatic action against the bacteria susceptible to the sulfonamide and against the tuberculi or tubercular bacillus. This sulfone is effective against the bacteria which are susceptible to sulfonamides, which effective against the tubercular bacilli, that is T, that which is defective, which is effective in the treatment of the TB. We see the adverse reaction of the sulfones. Sulfones are potentially toxic drug. They commonly cause the anorexia, nausea, and vomiting. The allergic reactions like dermatitis and the drug fever may also be occur with these sulfones. Other toxic effects include the nerve damage, hematuria, bleeding which is found in the urine, nerve also damaged due to the sulfones. Then we see the preparation and dose of it. Dapsone or DDS. 100 milligram tablet is available, which is used specially used for the in the treatment of leprosy and in the treatment of TB also it may be used. The first week, though we know that the leprosy affect on the neurons, that means its treatment is the long term treatment is required for that. The first week we required 100 milligram daily for the patient. Then the next 4 weeks to 25 milligram dose twice a week. The dose may be changed with the weeks. Then the 5th and 6th week, 50 milligram twice a week. First week 100 milligram, second the proportion much smaller, about 1/4 portion. Then again dose will be increased in 5th and 6th week. After that, 7th and 8th week, again dose is increased up to the 100 milligram twice a week. And thereafter, 100 milligram thrice a week with the higher dosage will be continued. Then it is necessary to introduce the rest period after every month to prevent and treat all the possible adverse reaction of the drug. Though we discussed the sulfones have some adverse effect, so after the month or rest of the some period to treat the possible adverse effect of that drug. Dapsone injection is available in 20% W by V. suspension of dapsone in Arachis oil, dose is 0.2 ml intramuscularly, weekly is available, gradually increase to the maximum 0.8 ml weekly. Then respiratory sulfones are available. It is given intramuscularly in a single dose of 0.25 mg and give effective blood levels of DDS for 70 to 80 days. That means all the sulfones dose is required up to the months, not to the days one. Then we see the next drugs, diaminodiphenylthiouria, that is thiambustine. It has similar activity that of the sulfon, but it is less active than the DDS. Usually administered orally, but can also be given by the injections. On oral administration, it is incompletely absorbed and rapidly excreted. Unlike dapsone, bacteria rapidly develop resistance to this drug, hence it is used first 1.5 to 2 years of therapy followed by the dapsone. This drug or this therapy is also we required long term therapy up to 1 year or 1.5 year to 2 years therapy is followed by the dapsone. It mainly useful in the those patients who cannot tolerate the dapsone. The serious adverse effect are common, not common, but it causes the anorexia, nausea and vomiting. Then the next drug used in the treatment of the leprosy is the clofazimine. It has an antibacterial action in the dose of 100 mg daily and can be used to treat the dapsone resistance therapy. We know that dapsone produces the resistance. If it is produced resistance, then these other drugs can be alternative for that, that is clofazimine, which is the given in the dapsone resistance therapy. The next drug is the rifampicin. It is a mycobactericidal. It is used in a dose of 600 mg daily. The drug is less toxic than the DDS and can be combined with the DDS in the standard doses. This rifampicin is prepared with the combination with the sulfons. Then the next is the chawal mugra and hydrocarpus oils. Chemically, both oils are almost identical with the unsaturated fatty acid. Both are the unsaturated fatty acid. These are usually used by local intradermal injections. We reach towards the summary. In this session, we covered the what is meant by chemotherapy of leprosy, drug used in leprosy in that sulfones, diaminodiphenylthiouria, rifampicin, chawal mugra, and hydrocarpus oils. Thank you very much for attending this session.